Hi, this is Kerry Artek with Wicked Stocks, bringing you the daily Apple report for Wednesday, December 6th, 2023.
But before I walk you through the charts, as usual, just want to encourage you to please click like if you haven't already, subscribe to the Wicked Stocks YouTube channel, share the content, if you would, with friends and colleagues, and check out wickedstocks.com, where we offer a full suite of both daily and weekly analytical videos, just like this one. Daily analysis in the SPY and the Triple Q, that is the S&P 500 and NASDAQ 100 ETFs. Weekly analysis in the S&P 500 Index, the NASDAQ 100 Index, the Long Bond ETF, the TLT, as well as two individual stock picks a week that you never see on YouTube. That is eight a month that cater to the 3 to 5 week swing trader out to the 3 to 5 month near-term investor. We're always looking for at least 20% moves on those stock picks, and you can check out all of this for no cost for 5 days. We offer a 5-day free trial up front with a WickedStocks.com subscription. So sign up for WickedStocks.com, check it all out. If you don't like what you see within 5 days, you can cancel your subscription at no cost to you whatsoever.
On with the charts. Let's take a look at the big picture. Reminder that long term, like through 24, we're bullish above the mid 160s. This is a buy signal that was set off last May. We got a nice pop to the upside to the July high. We fell back to retrace to the mid 160s, held nicely, and then following the testing, the retesting of the mid 160s long term support, we closed above this descending channel top that is presently 183.76. All systems go to the upside longer term, anticipating 232.58 by some point in 24, could be perhaps by the end of the first quarter over the next 3 or 4 months. We've seen those kinds of rallies in this market before, and we're about a third of the way there anyway from the mid 160s low. So that is the big picture. And I might add that where is that chart? On Tuesday, we clearly settled above the 190.69 descending channel top. And we continue on up to this former channel bottom at 194.48 today. We pushed through it a bit, but backed away. You know, I'm just going to call 194.48 a minor point. You can treat it as a level that might contain buying pressures for a good part of the day. But really, we closed above the high from a couple of weeks ago. I don't have it labeled here, but it is 192.93. 192.93 is that high from a couple of weeks ago. And I think that offers decent intraday support that can contain intraday selling pressures, and above which, given yesterday's volatility and even Monday's volatility, we can test 196.45 today, where a daily high can be placed. Keep in mind that following the settlement about, 3 weeks ago above this 183.04 descending channel top, which is the same structure on the weekly chart at 183.76, we'd expected within 2 to 3 weeks of that, the 198.23 July 23 all-time high. You can see we're about 4 weeks into that, 3 to 5 weeks. Yeah, that'll give us another week. Having closed above 190.69, I do think by the end of next week, the fifth week of closing above 183.04, we should actually reach the 198.23 all-time high from last July. And of course, if we close today above 196.45, we will probably see 198.23 tomorrow. I'll also mention that if we were to close above 198.23 on Friday at the end of the week, this is probably just another 1 to 2 months away, 217.99, rising at a pretty steep pace and eventually converging over the next several months with our overall long-term objective at 232.58. You know, if you've done nothing yet, if you did not buy this market long-term in the mid-160s, nor did you buy it again above the 183.76 formation, your next show of longer-term strength would be a settlement on Friday above 198.23. And then if you've done nothing, you can still reach for 220 or 240 out of the money calls that don't expire. I would go 6 months out at least, even a year out. Yes, you're paying more, certainly, but you're preserving delta, the rate of change of the option relative to the underlying stock, and you're eliminating theta, the rate of decay, premium decay that occurs with options, especially as you're approaching expiration. So that is it pretty much in a nutshell. Let's talk downside today, that if we not only ease back but sell off to close back below 190.69, yes, a good high for the week, but over the following day or two, we should test this newly formed channel bottom that's based in part on Tuesday's high. 187.82 is our new solid pullback support. Very similar to the other numbers we've been watching all week when we have that descending channel bottom that held nicely for the last week or so. And it's still in the 187 handle. 187.82, if tested over the next few days, able to contain selling through next week. Once tested, we can round back up to the 198.23 July 23 high within 2 to 3 weeks or less of testing 187.82. And whether we fall back to the 183 handle long-term support has everything to do with whether we settle below 187.82. So not unless we close below 187.82, and I don't see that happening today, but if it did, then we've got a 3 to 5 day sell signal to the 183.04 to 183.76 region, where once again, a longer-term buy opportunity presents, anticipating 232.58 in the months ahead. Is there anything else to say? I don't think so. I will say that if we push through 194.48, just a minor point, 196.45 is likely, but I think holding above 192.93, the high from a couple of weeks ago, will keep 196.45 in reach anyway today. And breaking 192.93 does allow 190.69 today, where we can bottom out for the day. There is an up pivot there, and above which, over the next 3 to 5 days, we should reach 198.23. So 3 to 5 day swing traders are long, or should get long if given the opportunity, at 190.69, expecting 198.23. And 3 to 5 day swing traders, I don't know, do you go short with a settlement below 190.69? I think you can do an overnight short, because the very next day, we could wind up testing that 187.82 formation. That is your next 3 to 5 day buy opportunity if we were to break 190.69. And in terms of aggressively selling the 3 to 5 day time frame, I think it's either A, with a settlement below 187.82, or B, an approach to 198.23, because that's what's in reach over the next 3 to 5 days. Yes, we can double top at 198.23 for a day, for a week, possibly through the balance of December, but I do think that this high is very susceptible to violation given the series of buys signals that we've had over the last, well, half year. May settlement above the mid-160s, and then the more recent settlement a month ago above the mid-180s. And I think that that is all that needs to be said. I'm going to say one more thing, and that is check out wickedstocks.com. Take advantage of our 5-day free trial. Please click like, share, subscribe. I'll be back tomorrow with Thursday's Apple. You have a great day.